Hey, it's me, June, again, and I have a book for today's Expert Minute. And it's called I Live in the Future, Here's How It Works by Nick Bilton. And what's so great about this book is that here's a kind of a fairly intellectual guy. He works for the New York Times, and he lays out kind of how we're supposed to wrap our minds around the future of media, social media. He specifically works for the New York Times, so he talks about how the kind of the print media has changed. And I love the fact that he lays out a very, very concise case for how things have changed quite a bit in the way that we consume media. And so it was great as someone that consumes media to go, oh, I do that. But also, from a business point of view, how we should change things around a little bit. So one thing that was surprising is that he, you know, like I said, he works for the New York Times, and he was part of this like digital division, if you will. I don't know if that was the technical term, but so the New York Times kind of partitioned out this group of people to think about digital media and the future and whatnot, yet it never crossed their minds that people would stop subscribing to the New York Times, that they always thought they'd be part and parcel together. And I think so what ends up happening is he ends up canceling his subscription. And this is the point in history where newspapers are getting pounded by lower advertising fees, lower subscribers in general, and then a lot of online visitors, but not knowing how to monetize that. So it's kind of a sore spot when he himself cancels the whole subscription. And so, you know, again, it was really surprising that here's New York Times, kind of, you know, they're the leader in their industry, and they had enough foresight to put together a digital division, but they didn't realize how all-encompassing the digital world shift was going to be. And so, you know, that was kind of a head-scratcher for me. An easy way that it's kind of changed the way I even look at everything now, not just in business, but the media I consume or media we produce, things like the show here, is that he lays out this concept, and this is probably the crux of this book. He lays out the concept to say, media now is consumed in meals, snacks, and bites. And if we are not thinking in all three of those terms, then we're really doing a disservice to getting our message out there, because now the new consumer media, that's the way they want to consume things. Sometimes they have time and interest, so they'll consume the whole meal, or they'll buy the whole album on iTunes. But sometimes they don't want that whole thing, they just want a snack, so maybe I just buy two or three songs on iTunes. But gone is the day where you have to basically make someone buy a whole album anymore to buy the whole meal. If someone doesn't want a whole meal, they're not going to buy the whole meal. So it's really helped me think about, again, even for our show, how do we create content for you all that's valuable, but it's valuable in three different ways. It's valuable in a meal, it's valuable in a snack format, and it's valuable in a bite format. Obviously, social media is more about the bites. So it's really made me think about how I can change the way I communicate everything for my business, and hopefully it does the same for you. Again, it's I Live in the Future, Here's How It Works by Nick Bilton. Thanks a lot. See you next week.